uma nihlala kimi namazwi ami ehlala kini ngiyakucela enikuthandayo.
What is that, Masala? With your understanding.
Yini?
It's a principle.
Umthetho lo.
It means if you are not complying according to this principle,
omongenzi njengalo mthetho,
it's going to be difficult for you to ask something from God and God will give it to you.
Kuzoba nzima ukuthi ucele
kuNkulunkulu. That is a principle.
Umthetho lo kaNkulunkulu.
This is the principle.
Inqubo kaNkulunkulu.
If you abide in me,
uma nihlala kimi,
and what?
Nani nihlala.
And my words. Yeah, come on, come on. If you abide in me,
manihlala kimi,
and my words,
lezwi lami,
whatever that you are going to ask to God, whatever that you ask from God, it shall be given to you. No. But this is a principle. As long you abide in me,
mawuhlala kimi.
It's just as simple as a principle. If you abide in me, how to abide in him? Because the person asks, how to abide in Jesus?
Ihlala kanjani
kuJesu? Because Jesus is not here.
Ngoba uJesu
akekho. Jesus is not here.
uJesu
akekho. And I don't know Jesus. I never seen Jesus. Angimazi
futhi angizange
ngambone. Only accept Jesus. Angibazela. You only accept Jesus. You never seen Jesus.
Angizange ngambona
ngambone. But this is how you abide in him.
Ihlala yokuhlala
kuJesu. My words, what are his words?
Oh my izwi.
What are his words?
Yini izwi?
This is Bible. That menu, this is a menu. This is the thing that God talks about it.
Yes.
Tell your neighbor, this is the manual.
Not a manual.
This is not a Bible. This is the manual of your life. If you don't comply with the manual, this is the manual. You will lose the benefit. Listen to me, the Bible is not just the Bible. The Bible is a manual. You need to use the Bible as a manual. You need to know everything that is in the manual so that you'll be able to enjoy the benefits of Jesus, because everything is in the Bible. Everything is in the manual. If you stick in the manual, there are people who are not on fire. Who are not on fire. Who are just lukewarm in the church. But they have everything.
But bana yonke.
You can judge them because they are not on fire. They are lukewarm. But they come every day in the church. But when you check their life is in order. Why? Because they know how to enjoy the benefit of Christ.
Oh yes.
The only thing that they do, they make sure that they stick on the manual.
Amen.
Because the manual doesn't tell you that you need to be on fire every time. The manual gives you the principle how to be successful. They know how to be successful. They stick on the manual. They enjoy the benefit that you're supposed to enjoy. But because you are lazy to read the manual, you are lazy to abide on the manual, you are lazy to make the manual your friend.
It's
the manual. You need understand your manual.
Fana ukuqonda ukuthi yini esebhayibhelini.
Now the Bible says,
let the Bible,
those who abide,
labo abahlala kimi,
in me,
kimi,
how to abide in him,
uhlala kanjani kuye.
That is a principle.
Unqobo leyo.
I hope you understand clearly what I'm trying to explain to you.
Ngiyathemba ukuthi uyayizwa.
Not to abide in HLC.
Ungahlangani nje HLC kuphela.
It's good.
Kuhle lokho.
In the church. But don't abide in the church.
God must ukuhlala ebandleni.
That word abide.
Leli gama elithi ukuhlala.
It's more than ukuhlala.
Akukhona nje.
Esontweni uyahlala. But uNkulunkulu uyasibophezela.
Uyayibophezela. Amen.
You must have a place where you gonna sit and but you need to be careful. Ungahlali ebandleni ugcine sowuyibandla, but ungazange uzibophezele kuJesu, ngoba ama benefits are not from the church, the benefits are from Jesus. That's what I'm trying to explain. So to abide, that word abide is more than
the word sitting.
To abide, ukuzibophezela, come on. Ukuba abide,
If you abide in me,
something like this. I'm abide.
no Christ.
No mudlangisa bam. No man abe ngiyahamba kushuthi kulapha.
Unam.
Yebo. Noma ngabe yena uyizwi yale mehamba kushuthi nami ngenze njani.
Ngihamba.
We are but umuntu ohleli masikhala bam. Uma sihleli la. Uma ngabe shukuma udlangisa kumadlangisa. Uma ngathanda ngishukuma. Ngoba yiki into enjani bazalwane?
Esibophezela.
Ingakho nje uhlele ebandleni bangaphakade behleli tuze wangabahambile wangahamba ngoba ubungathandi ukuhamba. Awuyazi ngiyakhuluma mina ukuhlala kuhlukene noma abide. Ingakho nje babusho buhlela mangaba ama-elders abehleli tuze wakho apha manje yakhona wena wasala indaba ukuthi benihlele ebandleni ebandlweni kuyahlala but in God
siyayibophezela.
Wherever I go, wherever he goes, this is the meaning. So if you abide
almost perpetually
in him
Buye.
And his word,
let's relax.
You not just abide in him and leave his word. Because
Lord.
I told you that his word is our lifestyle.
I
abide in him. As I am abiding in him, I need to live now. I need to see now we abide. But now we need to live. We need to live. We need to live. So now when while we are living, it means there is tomorrow.
All right.
It means there is after tomorrow. Because we need to live. We cannot live with the principle. But we need to live in his lifestyle. Because the principle is in me. Me and his principle are one. But now the Bible says, if you abide in me and my word, the word is a lifestyle. Wherever we move now, we are using the word. We are walking according to his word. But we are together, we abide in his principle. Come on. His principle abide in me, but his word teaches me how to walk day for day. His word teaches me how to walk day by day. But his principle is in me. I am a bind with his principle, but to move forward I need his word, because his word is my lifestyle. Day by day when I wake up in the morning, I make sure that the word gives me the direction how to walk, how to face the challenges, how to respond to the challenges. When the word tells me if I am facing challenges, the word will tell me how to respond. But before I respond, because each and every day when I am walking, I always listen to his voice, because the truth of his voice is to remind me about his word. The truth of the Holy Spirit is to remind me about his word. It means every day when I am walking, when I am waking up, I need to make sure that I listen to his voice. Although I listen to his voice, but I am abiding in his principles. His principles are together. Me and his principle, we are one. But each and every time when I'm facing any challenge, the voice of God, that is the Holy Spirit, will remind me about his word. That remember, when you are facing a challenge, this is how you respond. When I listen to his word, when his word remind me about his word, the thing that I am doing, I have to see the principle. The word, the Holy Spirit reminds me about his word. When the Holy Spirit reminds me about his word, when I receive the word from the Holy Spirit, regards the challenge that I'm facing, is to see the principles. Which principle to apply?